Persons of the Philippines' anti-communist insurgency task force have been ordered to stop making any remarks on community pantries. That's after Lieutenant General Antonio Parlade Jr. and Presidential Communications Undersecretary Lorraine Badoy drew flak for red-baiting community pantry organizers. National Security Advisor Hermogenes Esperon Jr. issued a gag order insisting that the National Task Force to End Local Communist Armed Conflict is not against the spirit of unity and cooperation embodied by the community pantries. Senator Franklin Drilon says Parlade should not get away with calling senators stupid for seeking to remove him from the task force and to defund the agency.
Ngayon lang ako nakarinig ng isang official ng armed forces o kahit sinong kawani sa pamahalaan na tatawagin ang mga senador na estupido dahil hindi magkatugma ang aming opinion. Kahit po sa media, hindi kami tinatawag na estupido. At hindi po marapat-dapat at dapat huwag palagpasin.
The Quezon City Police District has yet to explain its social media posts that red-baited the organizer of the community pantry on Maginhawa Street in Quezon City. That's according to the People's Law Enforcement Board, which formally wrote to the QCPD last week.
Hindi naman po namin tinatratong kaaway ang mga police. Trabaho namin to conduct an impartial investigation. So sana hayaan naman kami ng PNP na gumawa ng aming trabaho at makapag-imbestiga so, sa tunay na nangyari noong araw na yon.
Meanwhile, Philippine Vice President Leonel Robredo slammed government officials who red-baited community pantry organizers for having misplaced priorities.
Napaka-misplaced, napaka-irresponsible yung ginagawa ng ibang mga opisyal ng pamahalaan na sa panahon ng gaya nito, yan yung iniisip nila. May lugar at panahon para sa lahat. Ang ngayon na maraming naguguto, marami na wala ng hanap buhay, malaki yung pangangailangan, dapat nga pag may mga ganitong activities ay sinusuportahan, di ba dapat nga gayahin na lang nila kesa nag-aaksaya sila ng panahon na maghanap ng diferensya.
Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio remains the top choice for president for the 2022 national elections, despite her insistence that she would not run. The latest Pulse Asia survey shows Duterte Carpio, the daughter of President Rodrigo Duterte, led the possible or probable presidential candidates with 27%, followed by the namesake son of the late dictator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., former Senator Bongbong Marcos with 13%. Senator Grace Poe and Manila Mayor Isko Moreno were tied at the third spot with 12% each. Senator and boxer Manny Pacquiao earned a fourth spot with 11%, followed by Vice President Leonel Robredo with 7%. Mayor Duterte was the most preferred presidential candidate in her home region of Mindanao with 60%, but she's the least preferred among respondents in Metro Manila at 12%. Meanwhile, Moreno topped the list of preferred vice presidential candidates nationwide with 16%. Tied in the second spot were Pacquiao and Duterte Carpio with 15% each. Ranking third were Senate President Vicente Soto III and Marcos, who each got 11%.